Hello friends, I'm Ananya and today I'm going to do this video to understand you this poem. The poem name is Sara Cynthia Sylvia Stout. Now this poem was written by Shel Silverstein and here is written about Shel Silverstein and about few things described in this green paragraph. Okay, so I am making this video to let you understand this chapter Sara Cynthia Sylvia Stout very clearly, and so let's start. But first I want to say something, that please like my channel, subscribe, and please share it also with your friends so that they can also understand this concept easily. Okay, so let's begin. Now first I will be reading this green paragraph. Okay, it is said cleanliness is next to godliness. Read this amusing yet thought-provoking poem penned by cartoonist, playwright and poet Shel Silverstein. He was also an Oscar-nominated songwriter and was born in the USA in Chicago. So it is said in this green paragraph that it is said cleanliness is next to godliness. Yes, it's true that cleanliness is next to godliness. And they are saying that we have to read this amazing poem, and this poem is written about Shel Silverstein. He was a cartoonist, playwright and an Oscar nominated songwriter too, and he was born in Chicago. So I want to request you think that I don't know more about Shel Silverstein and about Chicago, so please comment me in the comment section about Chicago and Shel Silverstein. Okay, so I'm starting. Sara Cynthia Sylvia Stout by Shel Silverstein. Okay, I'll be let you understanding this poem also with reading. Okay, so Sara Cynthia Sylvia Stout would not take the garbage out. She would scour the pots and scrape the pans, candy the yams and sugar the jams. And though her daddy would scream and shout, she simply would not take the garbage out. And so it piled up to the ceilings, coffee grounds, potato peelings, brown bananas, rotten peas, chunks of sour cottage cheese. Then it filled the cans, it covered the floor, it cracked the window and blocked the door with bacon rinds and chicken bones, trippy ends of ice cream cones, prune pits, peach pits, orange peel, gloppy clumps of cold oatmeal, pizza crusts and withered greens, soggy beans and tangerines. Now let me understand you these two paragraphs. First paragraph, they are saying that there was a girl named Sara Cynthia Sylvia Stout, and she was having many garbage, and her daddy always shouted on her and that take out this garbage, but she would not take the garbage out, and in that she would scour the pots, scrape the pans, candy the yams, sugar the jams, and many type of garbage were there, and she simply would not take the garbage out, but her daddy always shouted on her and screams on her. Okay, now in the next paragraph they are saying that it has piled up to the ceilings too, and there were many coffee grounds, potato peelings, brown bananas, rotten peas, chunks of sour cottage cheese, and it has filled the cans also and it covered the floor, and the garbage has cracked the window and blocked the door. And there were bacon rinds, chicken bones, trippy ends of ice cream cones, prune pits, peach pits, orange peel, gloppy clumps of cold oatmeal. And there were pizza crusts also, withered greens too, soggy beans and tangerines. So they were all in this garbage. Okay, so now let us turn the page. And the next page they are saying that later the garbage rolled down the hall. It raised the roof, it broke the wall. At last the garbage reached so high that finally it touched the sky, and all the neighbors moved away and none of her friends would come to play. And finally Sara Cynthia Stout said, okay, I'll take the garbage out. But then of course it was too late. The garbage reached across the state from New York to the Golden Gate, and there in the garbage she did hide. Poor Sara met an awful fate that I cannot now relate, because the hour is much too late. But children, remember Sara Stout and always take the garbage out. Now they are telling you in these two paragraphs that, let us see this paragraph. Now in this paragraph they are telling that
later the garbage rolled down the hall. It raised the roof. It broke the wall. Yes, it is true. Here you can see also, it has rolled down the hall and it has raised the roof also and break the walls. And at last the garbage reached so high that finally it touched the sky. Yes, see, you can see that this garbage has touched the sky. Okay, and then all her neighbors moved away because of this garbage. See, all her neighbors moved away. Yes, and none of her friends would come to play, and her friends also would not come to play because due to this garbage. Okay, and so that's why Sarah, Cynthia, Stout were very upset. So then she said, okay, now I'll take the garbage out. But then, you know, it was too late. The garbage reached across the state. Yes, in this they are saying that, but then of course it was too late. The garbage reached across the state from New York to the Golden Gate, and there in the garbage she did hit. So now, because due to this, it was too late also. Yes, it has means it has touched the sky. And so, and she, and then from that she hit the garbage. Okay, then the poor Sarah met an very awful fate. Now you will be thinking that what is awful means she was feeling very, very bad, very, very unpleasant. Yes, and do you know that, and then she said that I cannot now relate it, I cannot do it as it was. So now he said, because the hour is much too late. Okay, so children, remember that Sarah Stout always takes the garbage out. So thank you. Please like my channel, subscribe, and comment me also about Chicago and Shel Silverstein. Thank you. Now I'll be meeting you in my next video.